So here we have the shrunken merino wool sweater. I laid it down and traced the pattern onto the fabric and left a little bit of room outside the pattern, so like a quarter to a half an inch extra. After cutting the material from the pattern, I made sure to take all the pins and fetched these velvet green gloves that I made. There's Penny staring at me so intently while I work. And then I base stitched the whole glove to make sure that the fabric does not move when I start stitching it on the machine. So I originally wanted to have these gloves have like a fold down where you can see the fingers of the glove underneath, but I didn't like how the green velvet clashed with the color of these periwinkle purple mitts, so I just kept it into a mitten. For this process here, I accidentally sewed the seam allowances backwards on the design of this mitt, and when I did that, I realized it afterwards, but then it turned out to be a really nice design when I did it backwards, and I decided to keep it. So here you can see the product, how it went backwards, and it turned out really well. And then I turned it inside out just to make sure that everything fits. I did a lot of hand sewing here. I basted the underglove onto the exterior glove just to make sure that it doesn't move because it is velvet. It is slippery under there. I ended up sewing the underglove to the exterior glove. And then I decided to embroider some catch stitch design onto the outside fold of the glove. I decided to go back in the day and add these strings to my gloves so I don't lose them, because they are merino wool and they're super warm and comfy. I definitely do not want to lose these gloves, so yeah.